Have you ever heard the time where I first almost literally bumped into the Queen, Her Majesty the Queen? Well, today I'm going to tell you.
It's gonna be a good day, great day with Myka Meier.
Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we're mixing it up. I'm going to take this day and make it story time. Now, today's story is a really good one, one of my favorite in my life. It's about the time that I first saw the Queen in person. So anyone who knows me knows that I love Her Majesty the Queen and have always admired her for so many different reasons. Well, here's the story about how I met her. Not my smoothest moment, let's just say, but I thought on this very special occasion, it is still to this day one of my favorite stories of all time, that I thought I would share it all with you. Okay, we're going to have to get cozy for this one because this story is a bit of a doozy. So, here we were. I was American, new in London, and I just loved polo, but I didn't know a lot about it. So my boyfriend at the time, my now husband, said, okay, let's go, let's get a couple friends, let's go to games, you can experience it firsthand. We're in London, everybody here, you know, culturally, so many people play polo. Let's go to a game and you'll learn, that's how you learn best about it. So we got my friends, are still to this day, some of my best friends, Jess and Jen, and my husband, and we went to a game that my husband had looked at, or my now husband, boyfriend at the time, had looked up, and it was in East Sussex. So, you know, it wasn't a highly publicized game. It wasn't some big, you know, really formal event. And we went and we brought picnics and we had rosé. And I remember saying, oh, I want to solve the divots. I want to make sure that we take part in that. And for anybody that doesn't know what that means, is in the middle of the game, it's almost like a little bit of an intermission. And the polo players and the horses get off of the field, and that's the one time that the audience, the spectators, are invited onto the field. And the announcer makes the call and says, okay, everybody, I'd like to invite you out to stomp the divots. Think about that moment in Pretty Woman. I think you all know what I'm talking about, right? Where she goes to stomp the divots. So, and the reason, divots are simply when the horse's hooves go on this beautiful manicured lawn that they play on, the hooves dig into the lawn and big chunks often come out. And so you see little brown kind of holes throughout this beautiful lawn. Now, that's dangerous for the horses because they could obviously break a leg if they were to trip or fall further into a divot. So it's really important that the audience then helps during this intermission time to turn over the lawn, again, those divots, and put them back into the holes so that the lawn is nice and smooth for the polo players to play on. So we went out on the field, we were stomping divots, and I was with Jess. And I remember looking over, there weren't that many people. And I remember looking up and seeing this woman very close to me, probably about 4 to 5 meters away from me, and looking up and making eye contact. And I remember just in my head thinking, ha, she looks like the Queen. And then I said to Jess, hey Jess, look, she looks just like the Queen. She probably hears that all the time. And Jess looked up and she kind of squinted, and as Jess was looking, and I could see her brain looking and squinting, and then a man right behind me kind of spoke over my shoulder, and I turned and he said, Madam, that is the Queen. And I remember looking up, looking at Jess, her eyes, because she'd already realized, me, the American who should have known better, but I didn't at the time, before my first etiquette class, I add in here. I look up and she, the Queen, has heard all this and seen all this, but very humble and with a great sense of humor, she was very much known to have. She puts down her head and I just see the smile. She just smiles and keeps stomping her divots and kind of turned her back and went off. Well, in that very brief moment of stunned shock, oh my gosh, I feel horrible, how disrespectful. I quickly, that was my very first time I'd ever curtsied, I quickly curtsied in the hopes that she saw, in the hopes that she felt it, because I was obviously mortified that I didn't recognize the queen. Now, the part about the story I love so much is that she just let me, she let me say, oh, she looks just like the queen, and didn't correct me, didn't wink at me, didn't, you know, laugh, didn't, you know, make me feel bad. She didn't look up and with a shocked face. She just looked down and with a gentle smile, kept stomping her divots and then turned away. And I just think that says everything about her and what good etiquette she had, what good sense of humor she had. And she must have been just chuckling the rest of the, you know, that moment, those few moments, thinking, oh dear, wait till she finds out. And it's still today is one of my favorite stories of my lifetime. So I wanted to share that with you because upon the Queen's passing, you know, it was just something that I thought, okay, this is the perfect time to share this story about when I first officially, or should we say unofficially, met the Queen. On that note, if you like this story time, please let me know if you'd like another story time because I love to tell stories. And I hope you all have a wonderful day, and I look forward to seeing you next time.